Hello and welcome to Weep Instructional Videos. My name is Stephanie, and today we're going to learn to add our own variables into Weep and to use these variables to make calculations and view the results. Here we have a model of a river with two demand sites, a reservoir, and a wastewater treatment plant. I'm interested in how much energy, specifically electricity, it takes to transfer water from the river through the transmission link to the city and to the coal power plant. How much electricity does this system need? Now, right now, Weep has no way of calculating this. Let's go into the data tree and we can add a user-defined variable. So I'm going to add it onto the transmission link because that's where the energy use is taking place. So I open Supply and Resources, Transmission Link, and here I'll click on City. And we can see we're in the Linking Rules button, and there are three tabs here, none of which are about electricity. But I'll go ahead and right-click on one of them, it doesn't matter which, and there's an option for Create. And here I can create a user-defined variable. The first thing that I'm going to do is look at my different options for category. These are the buttons that the tabs will appear under. None of these are what I want. You can see that they're categories for various different Weep nodes. But none of these are what I want. So I'm going to say Add New Category. And here, I'll add the new category, Electricity. Next, I'm going to give my user-defined variable a name, and I'm going to call it Electricity per cubic meter. Over here I can choose the units. The first drop-down menu is the scale. The second drop-down menu is the unit itself, which, as we've seen in other places, is divided into type. So we'll go right into energy, we'll click the little box next to it, and I'm going to pick kilowatt hours. Here I can write a description, so I'm going to say electricity required to move and treat 1 cubic meter of water in this link, including pumping. And we'll see where that appears. We can also put in minimum and maximum values. I'll go ahead and put in 0. And we can also make this a result variable that's visible. And here it will show up under the transmission link, but I could choose if I wanted it to be elsewhere. Down here, I can pick a default value, such as 0.5. Maybe I want to put that in as a default. And I can also say that this isn't editable. And now I'll click Save. And we can see that I have a new category up here, showing as a button. And here's my tab. My default value is written in here as 0.5, just as I put it in. And then here we can see that Weep is telling us it's a user-defined variable, and then it has the definition that we ourselves put in. Now I can change this. Say, for example, I want to say 1 kilowatt hour per cubic meter to the city. And then I can go to the coal power plant, and we'll see that the user-defined variable has also been created in the transmission link to the coal power plant. So what we learn here is that creating it in one place will create it in the same Weep elements elsewhere in Weep. And here I'll say that it only takes 0.3 kilowatt hours to transmit water to the coal plant. It might make sense to give this a lower value because perhaps the coal power plant is closer to the river or at a lower elevation, or because we specified that we're also treating this water to an appropriate level. Perhaps the coal power plant doesn't need so much treatment for the water that's coming into it. Now, so far we've added one new variable, and we can see that the value itself isn't changing over time, so the results won't be terribly interesting. Let's make another variable to look at total energy going through the transmission link. So I'm going to again right-click and say Create, and this time it defaults to the category that I want, electricity, because I started out there in electricity. And I'm going to name this one total electricity. And again, it will be in kilowatt hours. So under energy, kilowatt hours. And I want the result variable visible in the transmission link results. I can type in the same text again. I cut the video so you wouldn't have to watch me type. And again, I'll put down the minimum value of 0. It's monthly for current accounts. And I'm actually not ready to fill this part out yet, and I'll show you why. So right now I'll click Save, and I'm actually going to go into the Expression Builder. And in the Expression Builder, I want to remember that the total energy is going to be the product of the cubic meters flowing through the transmission link times the electricity use per cubic meter. Let me move this up a little bit. In the transmission link, I'm going to click on this, drag it down, and it will give me a set of variables that I can use to create an equation. So the first one will be flow, and its previous time step value, transmission link flows. And I want to put a multiplication sign after it. The second variable, I do the same thing. I click, I drag it down, and this time I select electricity. So times the transmission link electricity per cubic meter. And what I'm going to do is actually copy this and then open this up by right-clicking and saying edit. And I'm going to put that into my default value or expression. And then I'm going to say that this is read-only. That means that the user can't edit it. Now, I've showed you how to edit these, so you guys know how, but say that you're giving your Weep model to other people. They won't be able to change this variable. So I'll say save, and we can see our user-defined variable with the uneditable value. While you're here, if you want to organize this a little bit, you can go up to one of the tabs and right-click on it, say total electricity, and I'll say move right. This will shift the tab to the right side of electricity per cubic meter. And next we can go into results and recalculate. And we can see the kilowatt hours that I've entered in for transmission link electricity per cubic meter. And then if I go into supply and resources, transmission link, and total electricity, we can see the product of the total cubic meters that went through the transmission link times the electricity per cubic meter, which we see varies over time. This has been a Weep instructional video. Good luck on your models.